Keith Williams made his way to Maryville College all the way from Melbourne, a town located on the space coast of Florida. It was there that Keith began his sports career at Ugali High School in 1971. During his high school years, Keith became a powerful force for the football and wrestling teams while throwing discus for the track team in the spring. Upon graduating in 1975, Keith had earned 3 varsity letters in football while also earning varsity letters in wrestling and track. After receiving generous walk-on invitation from the University of Florida and being recruited by Ivy League competitor Dartmouth College, this talented lineman out of Melbourne committed to Maryville College under Coach Jim Jordan. Keith recalls Coach Jordan's visit to recruit him and teammate David Shankle. "Coach Jordan looked to my academic transcripts, my parents' financial profile, and my football video, and then made it clear that I was wanted and needed at Maryville College. Coach Jordan was a huge reason why I decided to choose Maryville College." Keith made the journey from Melbourne and arrived in the Highlands in the fall of 1975. As a freshman, he impressed coaches with his drive to compete for a starting spot on the offensive line. After playing extensively in the Scots' opening battle against Centre College, Keith unfortunately suffered a season-ending knee injury. Keith did not let this interfere with his career as a Scot, though. After having surgery, Keith focused on enhancing his career as a Scot off the field. While working on his academic prowess, this Scot also dedicated necessary time to rehab. His focus and dedication proved successful, and Keith was back at full speed, ready to prepare for the upcoming 1976 season. Under offensive coordinator Richard Taylor's multiple offensive scheme, Keith Williams excelled. This powerhouse started every game at right guard, and by the end of the season, defensive lines throughout the conference were winded. Keith helped lead the offense down the field, mowing over defenders in the process. The defense that featured Wall of Fame members Wayne Dunn, Lee Taylor, Danny Thomas, and Ken Hanna, MC's offense led a late charge that helped defeat number 3 ranked Hampton Sydney. The Scots ended the 1976 season with 7 wins, 2 against nationally ranked opponents Millsaps and Hampton Sydney, and a pair of losses. They narrowly missed a bid to the national tournament. This didn't change much when the 1977 season rolled around. With the talent of Keith and teammates, his Scots team was able to win 6 games in a row. The 1977 season was special for another reason as well. Keith's younger brother Brett joined the Scots at defensive tackle. Keith remembers intense and fierce battles in practice, including some one-on-one matchups. "I won most of those matchups, but not all of them," reflected Keith. Although the Scots were able to have one of the strongest starts in school history in 1977, injuries to impact players, one being Keith, contributed to 2 late-season road losses. Keith and his offensive line were responsible for impressive wins over Centre, Hampton Sydney, Millsaps, Rhodes, and Emory and Henry. The winning ways of MC football had returned, but a second serious knee injury halted a stellar career on the gridiron for our newest inductee. Sidelined in 1978, after his second major knee injury, Keith joined the team as a student assistant coach for new head coach Steve Fickert. While a student at Maryville College, Keith was given permission to complete a dual major in business administration and economics. Even with this academic workload and the rigors of being a college athlete, Keith managed to be named to the Maryville College Dean's List for each of his 12 straight semesters through graduation. Upon graduating with honors, with the highest GPA among seniors in the business department, and receiving the Bank of Maryville Award, Keith married his high school sweetheart, Lynn Wilson. This Scot went on to work in Atlanta and Florida as a commercial insurance sales executive until being admitted to the University of Florida College of Law in January of 1983. Keith used his dedication to quickly graduate from the law school and pass the Florida bar exam in 1985, and has been in private practice of law in Melbourne since then. Keith has gained a great reputation in the community and has maintained his own law office since 1990, specializing in civil litigation and trial practice. Keith and Lynn have 3 children, who all have graduated from the University of Florida and were all accomplished student athletes. Keith and Lynn also founded Faith Fellowship Church in Melbourne and remain active in various ministries and missions. Keith showed his love for sports by coaching youth sports for nearly a decade. At an early age, Keith Williams showed his passion for sports. After excelling in high school, Keith left his mark with Maryville College on the gridiron and in the classroom. For that, he will always be remembered as one of the greatest to sport the orange and garnet. He was a dedicated athlete who overcame adversity and injury to thrive on the field, in the classroom, and upon graduation. Ladies and gentlemen, 2013 Wall of Fame inductee, Keith Williams.